And a good afternoon to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for checking out the tropics with me, Jewel, here at the J7409 Weather Channel. Tracking map. I've updated it some. This is like a little bit of a head tracking map for you guys. Now, I said earlier in my earlier video this morning, I thought it would go up here by Tuesday, and it looks like it will. Now, before we even talk about paths, let me tell you something. There's a few scenarios. There's really three. You only hear most people talk about two, but I've had some questions in my comments, and I'm going to cover that too for Florida, okay? Now, we do have a few scenarios that can take place as we head in the upcoming week and next week. Now, it all depends on how fast they move. The jet stream, the highs, the lows, everything. I can tell you one thing, there should not be any wind shear or dry air to make this storm not ramp up and become a major hurricane. Okay, now, all the latest indications are suggesting that the storm track could vary across a wide swath, spawning from the U.S. East Coast northward to Eastern American Canada. And then there's one that shows it that it skirts away. Okay? It skirts away. And I hope that skirt blows away. That's what I hope right now. But I do want to stress to people, interest across the Caribbean and along the East Coast from Florida to Maine. I have heard this, some forecasters, national forecasters saying this now. And it's not out of the question. I'm going to show you why. So from Florida to Maine, you need to pay attention to the path that this takes, okay? However, I think it is going to be the U.S. and the Atlantic area, maybe a little further to the east of us. Let's hope it goes out some more. And this would be from September 13th through the 16th. Now, when I said several paths, one can keep going just like this, and big time. But it could go on and on and on right on up to Maine before it ever died out. Then, there is one that's going to get over here about like this. Okay? No matter where it gets at this point, it's going to be a major hurricane. Once again, looking like 13th through the 16th of September. Now, that third scenario where I included Florida, I had a lot of people ask me questions about that. I want to show you something. The NABGEM model. NABGEM model has it taking it, well, really it does this. It comes off about here. It starts over this way. And goes like this. Well, it could go anywhere when it gets there. It could get in the Gulf. It could swing back around and go back out. It could do anything. That's why I'm including Florida right now. Now, by no means am I saying this is going to happen to all my Floridian friends. No, I am not saying that. It probably won't, but there is that chance, and I wanted to include it. I want to show you this model right now, courtesy of Fox Hurricane, okay? My Fox Hurricane, thank you. This is the NABGEM model. Now, in about 5.5 days, they have it right here over the Dominican Republic. So we will move up some if we can. Just hold on. Really, I don't think this is going to pan out, folks, but it is the Navy model, so we can't rule it out. I mean, they got to know what's going on, too, you know? So, we're going to move this. It kind of deteriorates, but it's in this area right up here. Then it comes back up over the Dominican Republic. It goes away, then it starts to grow, and it comes on out into the area of the Caribbean down around Cuba. Now, I'm not saying this is going to happen. I just want to show you because I had so many people ask me if there was even a chance. Well, there's this little chance, okay? So that's what I'm showing you right now. I really don't think it's going to happen, but it could. So please keep up if you live in Florida. Taking a look at the up-to-date satellite right now, this afternoon around 2:22 p.m., this is what's going to be Hurricane Lee. Check it out. Pretty big circle that's going to form, huh? What I want you to pay attention to right here, though, you see all these little streamers coming off the sides here, going down in the ocean. Well, you know what they do? Those are the streamers from the cloud tops that make the strong, suck up the energy from the ocean and make the strong storm occur. And you can see, as we take this off, look again. Look at all of the streamers that are out everywhere. East side, north, west, south side. It's going to go to town. Yes, we already know this. And you can see over here, here's the island area right in here. There it is right there. Now, we got some more coming up, okay? We got some more coming up. This is one right here. Look at the cloud tops in it. 97. That's pretty cool. Pretty cool. But it's not going to stop there, folks. Look over here what's going to be coming from Africa. Look at these things. There's one. Let's see what it is. 104. This one. 106. That's not good, folks. When it gets that cold, whoops. 97. None of this is really good. Even when it's in the 80s, say like from 83 upward, that's not a good sign or something, okay? This storm, which is going to be Lee, it's going to be a major hurricane. But right now, these cloud tops don't look as ominous as they do over in Africa. That's because it's building right now, though, 89 degrees, and there ain't nothing to stop it. Okay, let's check in with the National Hurricane Center with their latest update this evening. 13, this is what it's called, 13, right in here. I may have to cough before all this is over. If I do, excuse me. Let's get back to 13 right now. Tropical depression 13. The winds are 35 miles per hour. Now, this thing also has wind gusts now of 47 to 48 miles per hour. The pressure, 1,008 millibars, located 12.5 north, 40.2 west. Any mariners out at sea, please pay attention and keep up with this storm because we got some more coming right behind it. Currently, it's moving west, northwest at 15 miles per hour, and it's going to keep moving west-northwest for a while until probably at least, I'd say, Tuesday or Wednesday of next week. We're just going to have to wait and see, okay? Then, disturbance number two's coming up, and this low pressure system is very big and broad, as you can see on the map, and it's associated with a strong tropical wave off the coast of West Africa. It's got a large area of showers and thunderstorms, and the environmental conditions do appear conducive for development, and a tropical depression could form over the far eastern tropical Atlantic during the middle or latter part of this week. The system is moving west-northwest at 10 to 15, and the system is expected to move across the Cabo Verde Islands Wednesday night and Thursday, tomorrow night and Thursday. And everybody that lives in those areas, please monitor this. 2 days, 30%. It's zooming right on up to 70% chance in 7 days. Now, the leftovers from Franklin, my goodness, and what, look at this. The post-tropical cyclone Franklin is located a few hundred miles northeast of the Azores, and it is forecast to move quickly east-southeastward towards warmer waters east of the Azores. Now, it could acquire some subtropical or tropical characteristics later this week or this weekend. It's just moving all over the place erratically, folks, between the Azores and Portugal. So, in 2 days, it's zero. 7 days, still very low. 20%, wherever it lands up, it's going to bring gusty winds and rain. Tracking map from the National Hurricane Center. Boy, oh boy, look, it's a tropical depression right now, but probably later this evening or early nighttime, it's going to change to Lee. So Lee's probably going to be born within the next 24 hours, okay? You can just call it Lee then. And it's going to stay a tropical storm until Wednesday evening around 8 p.m. Then it turns into a hurricane. And look, by Saturday, it's a major hurricane. And it's going to stay that way. They didn't go out quite as... I went out a little bit further than they did. My map brings it right about here, but everything else looks just about the same. So please keep up and pay attention. Please remember, a lot of changes are probably going to take place, okay? Keep up. That's important. We know how these things can change. And none of the stuff I'm showing you is wrote in stone. What we're looking at is these models give us an idea of what to go by in order to try to think about if we need to prepare or not. That's all simply they do. Yes, they do forecast tracks and this and that and all the other. But until you do the math equations to those things, you're just looking at a picture. You don't know. So, this is what it's looking like Saturday and Sunday. Over here in the northern island chain, as you can see, still looking like 40 to 60 mile per hour winds. At this time, it's still looking like 1 to 2 inches of rain in the northern island areas here. And as this progresses along Puerto Rico, you're probably going to feel some good wind gusts. I mean, it still should be well north of you. But it's going to be a major hurricane pretty soon. So you'll probably get a little rain around the edges here, and you'll get some wind gusts too, probably more than likely, coming up this weekend. There are no watches and warnings up at this time. I will get everything posted as they come in on the community page. Please keep checking it. When something comes in, I'll be sure and get it up. But the key message is right now, this depression is forecast to become a major hurricane. We knew that a long time ago, didn't we, folks? By this weekend. And it could bring impacts to the Leeward Islands by that time. Now, while it is too soon to determine the location and magnitude of these possible impacts, interest in this area, please monitor the progress of this depression and updates to the forecast, because it can change. It can change. If I lived in those areas where I just thought I might get a little something from it, as big as this hurricane's going to be, I'd be preparing. And you can see the wind speeds right here, okay? In the next 5 days, it's going to be 140 miles per hour. Look at that. Somewhere coming up, it's going to be like 130 probably when it gets around to the island area coming up this weekend. So, please make sure, do not panic, do not be afraid, just make sure you're prepared and you got your plans ready if you need to evacuate. I'm over at Tropical Tidbits right now because, thank you Levi for letting us use this. This is a very, very good site to do all some different wind models on, okay? And as you can see, I have the HAFS up there, and it's on Tropical Depression 13. I've got it set for September the 9th, and over here, it looks like the max winds that it has is around, right now, 146 kT. So what does that equal in miles per hour? 168 miles per hour. Here's a look at the wind speed with the HWRF. This is the hurricane model for wind speeds, one of the top ones, okay? Now, it's got it, I've got it set for September 9th. It's got it at 122.6 kt. So I'm going to bring that 6 off and say 125 knots. How much is that in miles per hour? 143 miles per hour. I'm showing you guys this so you'll see. You can't just look at one model because they're all reading something different. Here's the Euro model for the wind speed on September 9th. 98.4 knots. Okay, that's what it's looking like. So, what does that equal? Just around 100 miles per hour or a little more at this time. Could move up a little bit, okay? Now, I want to back up just a second on this Euro model. Right in this area, I know, it's probably 97 miles per hour at this point. This is real late Friday night, right before midnight, coming up on Saturday. Here we have the HMON, wind tracking model. You hear a lot of times from the National Hurricane Center that they're using this particular model. Well, on September the 8th, I've got it here, looking like it's measuring 119.8 knots. Okay? And that's what it's looking like on the 8th. Let's just bring this sucker right on up here and let it get together. Now, look, my goodness, 133.5 knots. So I'm going to round that off to 132. That equals 151 mile per hour winds. And we can't forget the GFS. I know it doesn't always pan out to be what it says, and I don't go by it generally. I go by all of them. Do the formula on all of them. And it's too long a formula, folks, or I try to teach you how to do it. But anyway, here this is. This is September the 10th, and it's got the wind at 108.9 knots. I've just took those 0.9 off, and what does that mean? 124 mile per hour winds. Very strong storm. It's going to be a Cat 4 or a Cat 5. It may get to a Cat 3 and kind of slow up, maybe go down a little bit, and then boom, it's going to come back up. Trust me on this. So if you live anywhere on the East Coast, I'll put it that way, and even up in parts of Canada, prepare for this. I'm not telling you to go put up boards today or anything like that. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about keep your eyes on it if you want to stay safe. That's the best I can tell you. And when it looks like it's going to be 2 or 3 days from you, you best pack your stuff. And if it looks like it's coming to actually hit you, you best leave. Because Lee is not going to be anything to mess with. Okay, my friends, you know, I usually don't say things like that in these videos, but I'm just telling you, this is going to be a major hurricane if things don't quit doing what they're doing, and it's nothing to play with. Look what Florida went through just a few days ago. Well, this can be worse than what happened in Florida, with the strength that keeps building in this storm. So, please don't take it lightly. What I really want you to do is just keep up. Keep up with the updates. You know, good and well, I'm going to put them out for you best as I can. 1 or 2 a day. When things start ramping up, you can count on 2. You might get 3. So, just pay attention. Make sure you go over to the community calendar to check on watches and warnings. Please don't forget to do that. Hey, thank you for watching. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what might be coming their way. I appreciate that. That helps out more than you know. Also, thank you for every single thing you do for me. I appreciate it greatly. Now stay safe, be smart, keep your eyes and ears open, and keep up with this storm, okay? I love you guys. Be blessed, and peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.